This video is to demonstrate the preparation and procedure to change the dressing of a vascular access device using a standard aseptic non-touch technique. A standard ANTT approach may be used when changing the dressing of a vascular access device and is commonly used when redressing a PVC. There is an ANTT guideline available on the NHS GGC clinical guideline platform. The guideline is useful as it contains advice surrounding the different situations or scenarios where you might use either a standard or a surgical ANTT. ANTT is also incorporated into each procedural template within the NHS GGC Vascular Access Devices Care and Maintenance Guideline. This guideline is also available on the Clinical Guideline platform. Throughout the procedure, you will be expected to follow appropriate infection control precautions with regards to performing essential hand hygiene and wearing necessary PPE. VAD dressing changes are required every 7 days or more frequently if the dressing is loose or soiled to reduce the risk of infection. I have performed hand hygiene and put on PPE. The first thing that I need to do is decontaminate the surface area that I will be using. I'm using a detergent wipe to do this. Any surface that can be decontaminated appropriately can be utilised. I'm now going to remove my PPE and perform hand hygiene. The next step is to get the equipment I need ready. I'm redressing a PVC, so the equipment I will need includes a sterile, semi-permeable, transparent dressing. These dressings are waterproof and minimise moisture buildup, both of which contribute to reducing the risk of infection. The transparent section of the dressing allows visibility of the insertion site to monitor for signs of infection. I've also got a wipe containing 2% chlorhexidine and 70% isopropyl alcohol. It's fundamental that I use these as this is the most effective solution at getting rid of any extrinsic microorganisms that might lead to bloodstream infection. I've performed hand hygiene again and put on new PPE. I'm going to use an aseptic non-touch technique to peel open the dressing packet. You will see that I'm using the dressing packet as a microcritical aseptic field to protect my dressing from contamination until I'm ready to use it. I'm now going to remove the PVC dressing. You can see that I'm picking up the edge of the dressing, stretching it and drawing it away from the skin in an upwards direction towards the insertion site. This will minimise the risk of the PVC being accidentally dislodged. I need to do a visual check of the insertion site to ensure there are no signs of phlebitis or infection that may indicate the PVC should be removed. I now need to perform hand hygiene and put on clean gloves. The next step is to decontaminate the skin surrounding the insertion site. I need to open the wipe using an aseptic non-touch technique, being careful that the outside of the packet does not come into contact with the wipe itself. I clean from the insertion site outwards in a circular pattern to avoid recontamination of an area that has already been cleaned. I'm doing this for 30 seconds and then I need to allow the solution to dry naturally. This also takes about 30 seconds. I can now apply the new PVC dressing. It is important when applying the dressing that you don't touch the sections that are going to come into direct contact with the skin, as this increases the risk of device-related infection. The wings of the PVC need to be secured using the securing strips contained within the dressing packet. These reduce the risk of the cannula moving. The securing strips should be applied parallel to the cannula and to each other. They should not crisscross over the insertion site, as this would obscure it and result in it being unable to be monitored for phlebitis and infection. The next step is to apply the dressing. This should fit closely around the hub of the cannula and should be flat against the skin with no creases, both of which prevent the cannula moving under the dressing and reduce the risk of infection. Following completion of the procedure, I can dispose of used equipment into the clinical waste, remove my PPE and perform hand hygiene. Redressing of the vascular access device should be documented in the associated care plan. To summarise, this video demonstrated a standard ANTT approach to changing the dressing of a vascular access device using a PVC as an example. The standard ANTT approach may be appropriate when dressing other vascular access devices.